I will say, I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Lord, I will rejoice and bless your holy name. So, Father, I thank you. I thank you for the opportunity we have, God, to gather in your house today. Lord, there's many things in the earth today that will try to hinder us from worshiping and being together. But I thank you, Father, we're the body of Christ. And I thank you that we're a branch of that tree. And Lord, as we gather together today, I thank you that, Lord, you're in our midst. And Lord, we can expect, Lord, the moving of your Holy Ghost. We give you glory. We give you thanks. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Everybody say amen. And find somebody, maybe you hadn't shook their hand yet this morning, shake their hand and tell them you're glad they're in the house of God and this is a happy day. Amen.
Freedom now, covered by your grace, witnessing your healing. Frustrating. I mean, it's good, right? But it's frustrating at the same time. You know, it's harder to do things in the rain, but there's so many songs that we sing about the rain and about God pouring out on us. And I think sometimes when we're going through that mess of the rain, we need to remind ourselves it's an example of God's overflow in our life. And that if we want it, sometimes you got to stand in it, right? And there's some problems sometimes that come our way. But we're refreshed by the rain, right? It brings life. It brings newness. You know, it takes you into a new season. You know, I think about the rivers that you can flow down, you know. They're taking you to a new season. So y'all just think about that this morning as we sing. But just invite the Lord to pour in you the way that He's poured out on this earth. Because we all need that overflow. We all need His glory to reign inside of us, right? So y'all just welcome Him this morning as we sing this.
Show me Your glory.
Glory surrounds me.
Even from the cleft of the rock like he was. Father, we thank you, Lord, that your glory is passing by today. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord, for the presence of your Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory.
Oh, so show me your glory.
Show me your glory. We heard that thunder behind us. Amen. I'm reminded that the Bible talks about how that around the throne of God, there's such power, there's such majesty that lightnings and thunderings around the throne of God. Amen. And for a split second there, it was like I had an inkling, a little taste of what it's going to be like. The first time that I'm in the throne room, that I see the Lord God Almighty sitting on his throne high and lifted up, and his train fills the temple. Amen. Let me tell you, if we had a true glimpse of the Father, we would never worry about our minute problems like we do. Amen? Because I want to tell you, we have a glorious Father that is so bigger than everything we will face. Let me tell you, maybe you've had some losses in life. Maybe you even lost some people that you love. But let me tell you what, that was on this temporal earth. I want to tell you, this is a setup for the next life. Amen. And if we live this life in accordance with Jesus and His Word, I want to tell you, we're going to be in that life with those that have gone on to be with Him. Amen. Glorying Him in the presence of God. Amen. And I thank God for the glory of God that He releases on the earth today. Amen. Hallelujah. And we're in an atmosphere today. We're in an atmosphere today to grab a hold of that. And I believe that you're accessing that presence. So let's praise Him today. Let's worship Him today because He is our Lord. Everybody say Jesus. In the Hebrew language, it's Yeshua. Everybody say Yeshua. Jesus. He is my Lord. Amen. Hallelujah, glory.
The kingdom of yours is a power.
Thank you, Father. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Lord, we worship you in this house. We give you glory, Lord. We stretch and we lean to you today, God. We thank you, God, for your nearness. We give you glory. Hallelujah. We give you glory. Hallelujah. You can be seated for a moment if you want to. Hallelujah. You don't have to. You can be seated if you want to. What hit me when you, Marla, when you said that? We need to stand in it sometime. Amen. We need to stand. Amen. Everybody say, we need to stand. You know, I don't do this every Sunday. In fact, most Sundays I don't. But something compelled me before church to walk out on the porch. I was the only one out there. And I just began to pray and walk the porch and begin to look around me. And of course, I was drawn. How can you not be drawn to that field across the street? Amen. And got to look at that corn. You know, it's not ready for harvest yet. The totality of what God has planned for that field has not come to pass yet. In fact, if you tried to harvest it, you'd get cow feed out of it. But there's a timing. Everybody say there's a timing. The moisture green over there. It's taking in the water, taking in the sun when it comes. And have you noticed how tall, how quickly that cornfield has grown up? Man, I want to tell you, I just begin to meditate on that. God says, be patient because that's what you are as a people. And he said, as long as you continue to stand, hallelujah, as long as you continue to stand in the ground and me and my spirit, I will bring you to full harvest. Amen. And I want to tell you, those stalks are there to represent our lives. Amen. How many of y'all want to be standing in the rain today? Amen. Standing in the rain. No matter, let the wind blow, let the rain. But I want to tell you, my roots are deep enough. Everybody say, my roots are deep enough. Will help me to stand through it all until I bring forth the fruit that God has ordained me to bring forth in this life. Amen. Hallelujah. You've got potential. The seed of God is planted in you. Amen. It's going to bring forth. There's a harvest day coming. There's a bringing forth in your life the things that you desire and pray for. But it will manifest only if we stand and we can remain planted in the right ground. Amen? How many of y'all know there's order to that field? There's order to that field. They're in rows. Amen? Hallelujah. And when we get in line with God, we're standing in God and get in line with one another. Amen? then the downpour, the torrential rain, the stuff that will damage us, it just flows right past us. Amen? Because we're standing on what? The high ground. Hallelujah. The high ground. So I just want to encourage you today. Stand in the Lord. Stand in the Lord. Amen? Stand there for. Amen? Having your feet shod in the preparation of the gospel of peace. Amen? Having the shield of faith. Amen? Hallelujah. The breastplate of righteousness. Your loins girt about with truth. Amen? Hallelujah. Amen. The helmet of salvation, which is the word. And the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Hallelujah. We've been armed. Amen? To bring forth the fruit. So keep standing. Everybody say, keep standing. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Lord, we receive from you today. We thank you, Lord, and I appreciate God's presence in this house. Hallelujah. Somebody say, glory to God. For the Lord is good, and his mercy endures forever. Amen. Well, I tell you, the weather and stuff has hindered a lot this morning, but that's not going to stop us. How many of y'all know ahead and stop the presence of God here in this service this morning? But this is Mother's Day, amen? And we want to take a moment to honor our mothers. So I want all the mothers to just come and join me may have a small group this morning, but that doesn't matter. This is your day. Everybody say, it's your day, amen? And I want you to come and just stand up here today. We want to honor you for just a few moments. Listen, if you're a stepmom or you've been in the role of a mother for anybody, we want you to feel included in this as well. Amen. Just come on and join us right now in Jesus' name. How many of y'all are thankful for these ladies of the Lord? Amen. Praise God. Praise God. And man, I want to tell you know, the greatest thing Mom ever did for me was take me to the house of God. Love me. Amen. Sing the word of God in me. So there's nothing like a mother. You know, I'm thankful for my dad. You know, I'm thankful for my dad. There's some things, you know, there's a bond between a son and a dad and that only he can do. And there's things I can talk to dad, I can talk to mom about. I mean, I don't know what I'm talking about. But man, I'm going to tell you what, when he's hurting, where do we run? Mama. Amen. Mama. And I thank God for my mama, for my natural mama. And more than anything else, I thank God that she knew the Lord. Amen. And I remember times when I was just a young boy. You know, I got saved at an early age, but, you know, just one night, a particular fear gripped a hold of me. Mama, come here, see you all right? I said, yeah, I started sharing with her. She said, son, she just knocked down beside my bed. Just said, son, you ain't got to worry about it. She said, you got Jesus in your heart, don't you? I said, yes, ma'am. She said, well, he's taking care of everything. He's right here in this room with you. And man, she just expressed that love. And I just thank God that I knew that I had somebody like a mother. You know, God, when he created mankind, he created Adam, but he saw that Adam was alone and it wasn't good for him to be alone. So where'd he go? He went to the inside of man. Amen. Pulled out a rib, made woman. Amen. So I want to tell you, when we say we're made after the image of God, to see the true image of God in his creation, we have to look at not only the workmanship of a man, but the workmanship of a woman. Because these are attributes of God as well as us as men. Amen? Hallelujah. And so I thank God for the role and the part that mothers play in our homes and in the body of Christ. We could not do this without you. I would not want to do it without you. Amen? So I want to thank you, moms. Only you will know what you've been through. And let me tell you, I know been ministering to mothers for long enough to know this. Sometimes on Mother's Day, the enemy will try to even bring up a sense of failure because of your mistakes as a mother. But I want to tell you what, none of you appear perfect. Amen? But you know the perfect one. And aren't you glad his blood covers a multitude of sin? He redeems the time for us. And it's amazing how God will restore things in love because of the love of mothers. Amen. So if I could tell you two things, a pastor, keep loving God, keep loving your kids. And however you can manifest that to them, hey, love them. If they're just attached, just love them with your prayers if you have to. Amen. But maybe some of them gone on to heaven. But just a, I love them and tell the Lord, you know, I'll do this sometimes. I say, I don't know all the workings of how it works. I know, I believe the Lord tells us that there's many clouds of witnesses that cheer us on from heaven. I believe the Lord gives them a glimpse over the portals of heaven. I don't pray to my lost love or those that have gone on before me. But I want to tell you, sometimes I'll tell Jesus, hey, Jesus, will you just tell them all my love today? Amen. Amen. So there's communication there through your Lord and Savior. Amen. I believe that. And so thank you for being mothers. You know, I was thinking driving in today. In fact, I remember it. I thought, mothers. MOTHER. What does that stand for? Let me see. What if I can get it? Let's see. Let's see. What was it? God help me out. It was good, I want to tell you. Well, maybe I need to share it later. It will come, amen. But anyway, pray for me. I get that. I want to share it with you. But anyway, I just want to pray for you. Amen. And we want to thank God for your mothers. And I thank God for the role you play in our households and in this house. Amen. So, guys, would y'all stretch your hands toward these this morning? Let's pray for them. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you, God, for what these ladies represent. God, they represent a part of your heart, God, that cannot be mimicked or played the role of by anyone else except those who experienced it. Father, I thank you, Lord, for what they've done as mothers. And I thank you today, God, that, Lord, as they rest in you, they know that they've only been able to function as a mother by your help. So, Father, bless them. Bless them for being vessels in your hands. Thank you, Lord, that, God, there are mothers that are in the house of God today. Lord, make it a priority of you and your word and your love. So, Father, measure that love that they've given back to them in the name of Jesus. I pray every need be met of theirs, God, that they face in this life. And I pray that you bring great fellowship and goodness and love to them this day. Bless these mothers today. And we give you praise and glory and honor for it all. In the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody did agree to say, amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hey, Wayne, you got your phone? Would you take a picture of these ladies together? Why don't y'all just get closer together, put your arm around one another, just to share some love there. Why don't y'all take a picture of these great ladies? And we appreciate you, what you mean to this house. And to the Lord, the King of God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Give them a hand out. And the lady before y'all sit down. Sorry, Pastor Donna, as a lady of this house, she wants to just to pass out a gift to you guys and say Happy Mother's Day to y'all. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Bless them real good, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, would y'all like to give to the Lord this morning? Isn't he worthy? Amen. Hallelujah. I just want to thank y'all so much, God. Thank you for just your continuance in giving. I want to tell you that God is faithful. And as you release it from your hands, I want to tell you what, it's not bye-bye when you give it away, when you give it to the kingdom of God. How many of y'all know that? And you're planting in something way bigger than you are. Amen. So praise God. We just appreciate your giving. Amen. And what God is doing. And what I can, when I see seed given, and some of you have stepped up and given in ways that I know you've had to be moved on, God, to do it. And I know this, man, that excites me because I know that God is moving on that seed. Amen. Man, he's going to bring a return. It's going to be more than you can handle, more than you can carry, and he will cause it to give you more seed and more blessing in Jesus' name. So how many are glad for that? Well, take whatever represents your giving this morning. Let's speak and pray a blessing over it. Just say this with me. Say, Father, I thank you that your word is true in every area of living, from salvation to healing to my finances. And Lord, I thank you that you designated a part of my finances that you said is yours, just like that tree in the garden that was yours. So Lord, I honor what is yours today. I give it to you with faith and expectation. And Lord, I give in obedience in exactly the way, exactly amount you've told me to. I give it cheerfully today with excitement, knowing your anointing is on it. And I give it not only to the church is your vehicle. I give it to this house because it represents your house. And I thank you, Lord, that your blessing will be upon it. Many souls will come. Many lives will be affected because of what is seeded into your house. And so I give it today, and I thank you, Lord, that the blessing of the Lord will be upon this house, your kingdom, and my house. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on and give as the Lord will lead you to this morning. God bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory to God. Everybody say, bless them real good, Lord. Amen. Move in their midst in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Well, somebody say, hallelujah. The Lord is good. And his mercy endures forever. Somebody say, mercy, mercy, mercy. You know, it's interesting that Jesus, when they described Jesus in the Word, they said he was full of grace and glory. Amen. They didn't say he was full of mercy because he didn't need the mercy of God. The mercy of God is when we don't get what we deserve. Jesus never sinned. Amen? But what is the grace of God? It's the empowerment of God. And Jesus was full of the empowerment of God to live out the glory here on earth. Amen? So I'm glad. I'm glad. How many of y'all are glad that Jesus is our example? Amen? And we ought to live out his glory every day of our life. Hallelujah. So how many of y'all know we ought to check our glory meter sometime? Amen. We ought to be sure that, you know, here a few years back, it's still popular saying WWJD. What would Jesus do? Amen. What would Jesus do? Are the actions you're acting on and doing, are they giving glory to God? Amen. Are the words you're saying and coming out of your mouth giving glory to God? Amen. How many of y'all know we need to check ourselves sometime? Amen. Because if we're new creatures in Christ Jesus,
hallelujah,
the old should be
passed away.
All things become new. Amen. Amen. That means I ain't doing it like I used to. I don't like the things I used to. Amen?
Amen, amen?
There's a popular thing you do on Facebook now. Somebody share something, you can like it. I'm going to be very careful what I like. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Somebody's cussing or boozing up or doing something that's stupid. Why would I want to like that? Because what you're doing is giving an avenue for somebody to think of you maybe in another light. And what does it do? It's like I used to, many conversations like this growing up. You know, I don't believe smoking is going to send anybody to hell. Amen. It's going to make you smell like it, but it's not going to send you there. Amen. But listen. It may affect your testimony. Amen. Because it's a physical thing. We all got physical issues. You know, I don't need to eat so much sometimes. Amen? But here, we all got issues. But let me tell you this. We need to evaluate because if it could be a stumbling block, and there's certain things in this life that people attest to Christianity. You can call it our culture or whatever. But if we're cussing all the time, or we're smelling like a brewery, in Jesus' name, help us with that one. I don't want to get on that one. Or if we, you know, smell like, how many of y'all know, it's going to affect people's testimony. Amen? And so some people, they don't care. They're gonna listen to you, but others may cut you off because of what's presented there. Amen? Y'all hear what I'm saying? I have no idea. I did not plan on saying this today. God help me. And it's Mother's Day. Amen? But maybe God put that mother anointing on me. Amen? To talk about that. But anyway, listen. I want to guard my testimony. Amen? And I want to make sure people are hearing the right things and I'm agreeing with the right things. Amen? And let me just go one step farther. If you're a faithful person in this church, that's not only a reflection of you. You got a responsibility. You're a reflection of this house. Amen? And if we're acting like crazy people out there, amen, in an attempt to say, hey, God loves everybody. We know God loves everybody. But is God all right with everything we do? Amen? Hallelujah? And it's a reflection of, it may be a reflection of this house. It's like, man, I don't want to go to that church because they must think everything's okay. Y'all hear what I'm saying? So what am I saying here? I'm awakened. I'm talking to you as a mother this morning. Amen. Let's awaken to our responsibility as the body of Christ. Amen. Everything that we do, everything that we align ourselves with and act upon, I want to tell you what, it is reflection. And it's reflection way beyond who we are. Amen. Y'all hear me this morning?
Amen.
Praise God. Thank you for letting me pastor a little bit this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Somebody say glory to God. Well, y'all ready for the word this morning? Hallelujah. That was a free one right there. Just thought I'd give it to you. But take your Bibles, if you will, and turn with me to John chapter 4. John chapter 4. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Now let me just say this to you. Ain't none of us arrived and none of us perfect yet. Amen. How many of y'all still a work in progress? Amen. But look, if God's gracious enough to do it, we need to take his help and put forth the effort to change some things in our life. It's time. It's like Paul said to one of the churches, he said, man, it's time for y'all should be teachers by now. Is what he said. Amen. It's time for y'all to grow up. It's time for us to grow up. Amen. I've known people been serving God for, and I'm not talking about amen. I've been know people who've been serving God for 60 years, and they still need to grow up. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Amen. So how many of y'all want to be a spiritual grown up? How many of y'all want to be serious? And if there's ever a time to be sober, and I'm talking about soberness of mind, it is now, because Jesus is about to return. Would somebody say amen? Hallelujah. Well, that was a loving message. Well, let's go to John chapter 4, if you would, and turn with me over there. I'm excited to share this. The Lord has put on my heart this morning. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Everybody say, God loves me. The pastor loves me. God loves me so much, he'll speak truth to me because he cares about me. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't think any of y'all come to this church because you want a pastor that will just pat you on the head all the time. If I don't challenge us, we ain't doing our jobs. Amen? Let me tell you what. A lot of the challenge I speak to you is because God challenged me with it before I got this far. Would somebody say amen?
Amen.
So we're all a work in progress. Amen? And I want to grow. I want to grow. Amen. How about you? Well, stand with me if you will. Let's go to this great chapter in John chapter 4. Now, on this Mother's Day, we're going to be sharing the story that I preached out of several times and many times. I think one pretty recently. But it's a story about a woman. Now, the word doesn't tell us specifically that she was a mother. She may or may not have had children. I don't know. There's a real good chance that she did, but we don't know that. And whether she carried a baby inside of her or not, she had an encounter with Jesus. And after her encounter with Jesus, she had something inside of her she could not keep inside of her. But it had to be delivered, and it busted forth, and it sprang forth from her, and it became an overflow in her life. So read with me, and let's start reading with John chapter 4 and verse 5. It says, "Then cometh he to a city of Samaria, which is called Sychar, near to the parcel of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore, being wearied with his journey, sat thus on the well, and it was about the sixth hour. Then cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, Give me to drink, for his disciples were gone away into the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, How is it that thou, being a Jew, askest me of a drink, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. And Jesus answered and said unto her, If thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith to thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldest ask of him, and he would have given thee living water. And the woman saith unto him, Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou this living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well, and drank thereof himself, and his children, and his cattle? Jesus answered and said unto her, Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up." Everybody say, springing up. "Into eternal life." Everybody say, springing up. Now we'll stop right there. We're going to read some more of this story. But first of all, we're going to pray. And I want to just share with you that I'm going to share with you today. And this is my message. Living in the overflow. Hallelujah. Living in the overflow. Amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this word today. Thank you that your word is true. And thank you, Father God, for the anointing on. I pray, God, that you'd help us to receive exactly what you're speaking to our hearts today. I pray that we'd hear the voice behind the words. We pray that we'd hear what the Spirit said to the church today. And I pray, God, that every one of our hearts, every one of our lives would be open, God, for your voice. I rebuke every hindrance of the enemy in Jesus' name. And I pray our ears, our hearts and our minds be wide open, Father God. And I thank you, God, for speaking this to us. And I pray that you would just equip us and make us, Lord, full people. Full, so full that we're overflowing and living in the overflow. We thank you, God, for it. We praise you for it in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen and amen. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Reading on here, verse 15 says, "And the woman saith unto him, Sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come hither to draw. Jesus saith unto her, Go call thy husband, and come hither. And the woman answered and said, I have no husband. And Jesus said unto her, Thou hast well said, I have no husband. For thou hast had five husbands, and he whom thou now is not thy husband, in that saidest thou truly. And the woman said unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet." How many of y'all are thankful for the gifts of the Spirit that in this case invaded the portals of time? Jesus was full of the Spirit of God, and so the gifts of the Spirit always flowed out of him. And this was the Holy Ghost, the gift of knowledge in operating, telling this woman what was going on in her life. How many of y'all appreciate that God does that sometimes to get our attention? Amen. She says, the woman saith unto him, "Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Our fathers," and then she kicks into religious talk. Amen. "Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and you say that in Jerusalem is a place where men ought to worship. And Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour cometh when we shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. You worship, you know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshiper shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him." I love that conversation because she was saying, okay, you told me all this, and I perceive something's going on here. You're a man of God. So she started talking religion. Amen. Where should we pray? And Jesus, I'm glad he cuts off religious talk. Are y'all glad of that? He got off the religious talk and started talking spiritual talk. He said, let me tell you, God's looking for those who will worship him. It doesn't matter where it is. Can somebody say amen? God is a spirit, verse 24, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. And the woman saith to him, I know that Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he has come, he will tell us all things. And Jesus saith unto her, boy, I can imagine it was like a big sword going through her heart when he said these words, I that speak unto thee am he. At that moment in time, the truth was telling her the truth. And that woman had to make a decision to believe that or not. Oh, well, let's see what she did. And upon this came his disciples and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, what seekest thou, or why talkest thou with her? The woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city and saith to the men, come and see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went out to the city and came unto him. In the meanwhile, his disciples prayed him, saying, Master, eat. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat that ye know not of. Therefore said the disciples one to another, hath any man brought him something to eat or ought to eat? And Jesus saith unto them, my meat is to do the will of God, of him that sent me, and to finish his work. Say not ye, there are yet 4 months, and then cometh the harvest. Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to harvest. And he that reapeth receiveth wages, and gathereth fruit into the life eternal, that both he that soweth and he that reapeth may rejoice together. And herein is that saying true, oh, one soweth and another reapeth. I say to you, to reap whereon you bestowed no labor, other men labor, and you are entered into their labors. And many of the Samaritans of that city believed on him for the saying of the woman, which testified, he told me all that I ever did. So when the Samaritans were come unto him, they besought him that he would tarry with them, and he abode there 2 days. And many more believed because of his word, and said unto the woman, now we believe, not because thy saying, for we have heard him ourselves. Hallelujah. And know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world. Hallelujah. I love that story. Amen. Don't you appreciate that encounter that Jesus had with this woman? Hallelujah. Now we believe him for ourselves, the people said. Isn't it neat when you have an audience with the King yourself? Isn't it neat where you don't have to draw on somebody else's experience with the Lord? Isn't it good that we don't have to depend on somebody else to do everything with God? That's why I will never be in a booth for you to come confess your sins to me. I can't do nothing with that except know your dirty laundry. Amen? Now look, now hear me. The Bible says confess your faults one another. Sometimes God will give us a confident person that we adhere to and pastors are that a lot of times for people that they need to get some things off their chest because they need prayer to overcome. But I don't have to go confess, and you don't have to go confess every sin and failure to some man so that he can intercede to God on your behalf. How many of y'all know through Jesus Christ we have an advocate with the Father? There's a lawyer, an advocate already hired for us that has an audience with the God of all creation. And all we have to do is in the name of Jesus that grants us access, go and we access that throne room, which we sensed this morning as we was praising God. Aren't you glad of that this morning? Glory to God. So our challenge, y'all, is to be like this woman. She went back to that town and she spilled everything that Jesus did. Isn't it amazing? She left her water pot. She went there to get natural water. Oh, she left with living water. Amen. She's asking Jesus how to access this living water. He already gave it to her because he revealed who he was to her. And she went back and she couldn't help it because she was so, can you imagine how this woman, and look here, think about this woman. This was not a churchy woman. This was not a godly woman. Amen? In fact, you know, let me tell you, we think about her. And who knows in this conversation, it kind of takes a twist. You know, when Jesus said, if you knew who he's talking to, you'd ask him for living water and give it to you. Oh, and she kind of just said, well, how would you draw this living water? She may have even been a little flirtatious with Jesus. Because we know she was the woman of the world. Amen? Because the Bible says she'd been married 5 times. Amen. And the one she's living with was not her husband. Amen? So that's why I say, I don't know if she may have had some kids. The Bible doesn't tell us that or not. But Jesus loved her enough. And God, the Father, loved her to put Jesus in the path of this woman in the process of her natural life to be going after a natural resource. And Jesus stopped and talked to her. And because of that, she became full of something that she could not contain and ran back to town and spilled it on everybody else. Hallelujah. How many of y'all would agree with me? This woman was living in the overflow. Yeah. Amen? We've got to do that as Christians. We can't afford to be just always wanting to get filled up. Oh, give me something. Give me something. Just give me something to wet my tongue with. You know, no, we got to live in the overflow. And it's our choice whether we put ourselves under the spigot of His glory, under the spigot of His word, under the spigot of His presence, and remain full that so we can spill over on everybody else. Living in the overflow. Let me tell you what. The only way as a minister I can survive and preach messages to you that have any power at all is my messages have to come from overflow. Amen? Amen. If it's just written down, all that is, you know, I mean, you don't need no more sermons. Amen? I don't need sermons. I need messages from God. Hallelujah. And the people out in the world, they don't need sermons. They need messages from God. And there's only one place that comes from. Overflowing. We got to live our life in an overflow manner. Staying full of Jesus. Staying full of the presence of God. You're doing that one way by being in the house of God this morning. Because the spigot is being released. And you're either can pour it out or you can contain it. And if you contain it and let it fill you up, then chances are this week you're going to be spilling out on somebody else. Would somebody say amen? Amen? Our challenge is to live our life in an overflowing experience of what God is doing for us. Amen? But to overflow, you've got to first be full. Amen? Now, how do you get full? How did this lady get full? She talked to Jesus. She talked to Jesus. Sometimes things are so simple, we try to complicate them in our mind. Man, how do we get an overflow? Just keep talking to Jesus. Amen? Amen. Just keep talking to Him. Just keep listening. Hallelujah. Just keep listening. I assure you, God is hearing the cry of His people. Amen? The cry of His heart. Hallelujah. Listen. Talk to Him. Listen to what He has to say. Because I want to tell you, just like with this woman, this woman didn't have any spiritual understanding whatsoever. All she knew was religious understanding that she'd been taught because she wasn't the upper echelon of Jewish tradition. So all she knew to do was ask questions of religion. But Jesus just turned it around and began to talk to things of the heart. Amen? And I want to tell you, sometimes we're praying. But what we're praying for is just we're so focused on our need. Amen? So focused on our need, we're not allowing ourselves to get down to the heart of the matter about what's really going on with us. Amen. Amen. I want to tell you what, I've been praying before for someone, God, we need this, or God, I need this. And man, it's like something, because I'm talking to Him. If I will listen when I'm talking to Him, then all of a sudden my prayer will shift. Amen. All of a sudden my prayer will shift. And it's like, oh, God, but you know what, man? I see this thing needs to be adjusted right here. And I begin to cry. And not it's like, oh, God, I'm sorry. And I do say I'm sorry sometimes if it's something I know I've done wrong, convicted of. But sometimes it's like, oh, I hear you, God. I hear your direction. You're giving me direction here, God. And you know what? Here's the important. I want you to hear this. It becomes a heart-to-heart with God. Amen? God has really been dealing with me about when I pray with all of my heart. Amen? Yes. Just some of our prayers are surface prayers, like where should we worship, in Jerusalem or somewhere else? And Jesus said, oh, no, that's not what it's about. And the Father seeketh us that worship Him in spirit and in truth. In other words, God, just bear your heart to God is what I'm saying. Bear your heart to Jesus. He is your very best friend. He loves you. He understands your weaknesses. He understands your turmoil. He understands it. If you're in a wrong place, He understands the things that got you to that place. But He also understands the road to recovery. He understands the road to get us in the position that we need to be so that we can have an overflowing existence that'll be more than just for us. It'll be for others. Glory to God. How me. I want to be overflowing with the glory of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus answered her natural questions, and he turned her thirst into spiritual questions. Amen? Jesus. I love it because Jesus didn't want to talk shop religion. He's just talking to her about life. Talking to her about water. See, that she was there to get water. Boy, she got water, didn't she? She got living water that splashed on the whole town. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of y'all know just talking to Jesus, just praying, it changes our mindset from natural. I remember days I used to have to go to work real early when I worked with Dr. Pepper, and it seemed like we always lived way, way far away from the plant. So I'd have to get up extra early and drive in. One time we were living in Mahia, and they gave me the Mahia route. So I had to get up and drive from Mahia to Waco to get my route truck to drive back to Mahia and finish my route so that I could drive back to Waco and get my vehicle so I could drive back to Mahia and go home. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you what. God knows where you are. Amen. God knows where you're positioned. And we've got to position ourselves to receive from him. Amen. And we're after one thing when God may be wanting to do another thing for us. Now somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. And I love that in verse 28 where it says this. It says that the woman then left her water pot and went her way into the city and saith to the men, come and see it. A man that told me everything I ever did. Amen. Left her water pot. She forgot the purpose of what she was there for in the natural. Why? Because she got something more important. Heart to heart. Everybody say heart to heart.
Heart to
heart. See, the point I was going to make a while ago was I remember getting up in the morning sometimes and had all that driving to do or whatever and all that time. But boy, sometimes I just rush out the door, you know? Rush out the door and I'd find myself 3 or 4 hours in my day and realize, man, I really hadn't even took time to pray like I should. But it was amazing on the days that I would take time to pray before I got into my day. Did y'all hear what I just said?
Yeah.
And communicate heart to heart with the Father. If I knew I was facing an issue that day, I'd say, Father God, this is what it is. God, help me with this. Please go before me. Get my mind right. And I commit this to you, Father. Order my thoughts and steps. And I don't remember every time. I said, thou shalt handle it like this. Say this to that person. No, I left and I didn't have any knowledge of what to do more than I had when I prayed. But there was one particular difference. I felt full. I felt like I had given this to God, and I left my house with the confidence of knowing God was doing things that I couldn't even do about it anyway. And I can't tell you, more times than not, more times the situations that I was concerned about on the work day, when I got God involved with it and went into my day full with him instead of empty trying to just deal with things, but full with him, the situations just fixed themselves so many times. How many of y'all are glad we serve a God like that? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. So we can get up full and overflowing just like this woman did by talking to Jesus. Amen. How many of y'all want to talk to him on a daily basis? Hallelujah. Be willing to leave your water pot. Put the natural things down and listen when God is talking to you. You may be in the middle of something. You know, I've had God wake me up in the middle of the night before. I need my sleep. How many of y'all need your sleep? Amen. I've had God wake me up in the middle of the night before to pray for somebody, and I may have try to talk God out of it. Y'all ever tried to do that? That's not a good idea to do. Amen. I've shared with y'all before a story when we went on vacation to Colorado the first time. And man, I didn't know anybody in that town. Ouray, Colorado, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place. And God woke me up at about 2:30 in the morning, said, pray for that local pastor, that church you just drove by. Man, I said, God, are you kidding me? I'm on vacation. Amen. But you know what? I was obedient to do it. God, I want to tell you, and I don't know what was going on in that man's life, but I know this. Maybe one day I will know. Amen. And I did what I needed to do. Allow God the privilege and the honor of being able to interrupt you if he needs to.
Yeah.
Amen. Set your water pot down if you have to. and let him pour into you, and it will change your life forever. Amen. And somebody say amen and amen. Now look, it's interesting to me. It's always interesting to me of that water is so many examples in the Word of God. And have we not dealt with water lately around here? We understand how water works, but there's examples that God uses. I want you to look at a couple of scriptures where God uses water and the force of water to explain spiritual forces. Look at John 7, turn a couple of pages. John 7, chapter 37 and 39, and Jesus uses that to talk about the Holy Ghost and the experience of the baptism of the Holy Ghost that would come later. He said in John 7 and 37 through 39, he said, in the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. And he that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet glorified. So Jesus uses the example of water and the force of water as an example of what the Holy Ghost is. How many of y'all know water? You live around here lately and watch the news or anything? You know that water has force and power. How do we even get most of our electricity or used to is through power plants built by water sources, because there's power there. Amen? One of the scripture, Ephesians 5 and 26. I love this one. Ephesians 5 and 26 says this. Talking about, let's back up. Y'all knew I had to do it at least once today. Let's back up here in verse 25. Husbands, love your wives. That's a good thing to do on Mother's Day. Amen. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it. How does he cleanse it? With the washing of the water by the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's power in the word. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Why? That he might present it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but it should be holy and without blemish. Hallelujah. That God used examples of water because it's a powerful source, and we've known that around here. Water can be devastating at times. And sometimes it's a devastating force. Amen? We've seen evidence lately of high water and the damage it's done, and even some people have lost their lives over these rising things. But I want you to go back with me in the Word of God and think about the examples of when water was destructive. Think about in Noah's day and how the flood came upon the earth, and what did it do? It destroyed all air-breathing living things upon the earth. Amen? Think about the force of water that was before the Hebrews when they stood at the Red Sea and the army of the Egyptians was behind them, and yet there was this force of water, the Red Sea, in front of them that hindered them and kept them from going forward to what God had called them to do. Amen? It hindered them. It trapped them. And then think about the stormy waters of the Galilee when the disciples were on their boat crossing to the other side and Jesus was asleep in the back of the boat. Amen? And let's be honest, we've been like the disciples. Jesus, is this a great time to take a nap or what? Now, my Bible says the Lord of Israel, he neither slumbers nor sleeps. Amen? But Jesus was a natural man. Amen? When he walked upon the earth, he was all God and he was all man. I think it's interesting. How did even this conversation with this woman at the well? It said Jesus was weary in his natural body. So he sat down to be refreshed at the well. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus was getting some sleep. He needed sleep because his spirit never sat down. It was always going, always communicating with the Father. But Jesus was walking in a fleshly body. He put his glorified body aside, walked in a body of a man so that he could feel all the intensity and the temptations and everything that we experience as men and women. Amen? So he took up on flesh, he came here, and he got wearied, he got tired sometimes. He was back in the boat. The storm came, and that storm came what? To take the disciples and Jesus down. Amen? But every time, everybody say every time.
Every time
the waters threatened to destroy God's church, even in the book of Noah, we know the waters of Noah's time, it was God allowed those flood waters to come to destroy. It was a judgment upon the earth. But how many of y'all believe there were some intense days in that ark? fear probably gripped their heart, especially when the force of the water underneath them lifted it off of the standards that ark was sitting on. Can you imagine the sound of that? What if this church started moving all of a sudden like this, and we begin to float freely? And the unique thing about that, in Noah's boat, it was like all these animal sounds going on. A little bit terrifying, don't you think? Amen. Fear had an opportunity to take the people of God down, but God did not allow it to happen. Every time, everybody say, every time, that waters threaten God's children, God provides. And listen, this is unique. Boy, God, show me the love of it. God provided wood and word. Woo!
Amen.
Say, God will provide wood and word. He spoke his word to Noah, and in obedience, Noah built the wooden ark. And as the destroying waters came down, God's people were lifted up. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Oh, the enemy would have loved to take those flood waters and turn them against Noah and his family. But the very thing that was destroying and judging upon the earth was lifting up those of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
How many of y'all know that's a great example of what's going to happen when that trumpet blast in the name of Jesus, as the flood of tribulation pours down upon the earth and we get closer, that God is going to say, at some point, this thing is rising too high, and we will lift up off of this earth. There will be a suspension of us. We will go to be with the Lord in the air forever to be with Him. Aren't you glad of that? And this flood of tribulation, these waters are not designed for us. In fact, Jesus even told the disciples, he said, just as it was in the days of Noah, so will it be in the last days. Yeah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Those waters could not destroy them.
Hallelujah.
God lifted them up. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God spoke his word to Moses. And in obedience, Moses stretched out his wooden rod over the waters. Amen. Hallelujah. He called out to God. God said, you do something about it. I put that rod in your hands. You stretch it over the waters. And he said, and this was unique. God said, you do this and I'll do this. God said, you divide the Red Sea. Now we know God's wind of anointing is what blew that forth. But he said, you do it. He took the action. He took the wood, that wooden rod, and he stretched it over. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. God spoke the word to Moses. In obedience, Moses stretched out his wooden rod, and he divided the waters of the Red Sea, and the people of God went across on dry ground. Hallelujah. I love that in worship today. And man, we was talking about that. And dry ground. Was that prayer meeting? Was that service? We was talking about that. Man, God is not going to let you get stuck in your way out. He'll provide dry ground on the way out. Hallelujah. Say, I'm coming out. Because God's provided the wood and the word. Hallelujah. He divided the Red Sea. People of God went across on dry ground to lead them. Listen, where did they go? And yeah, they got delayed 40 years because of their disobedience. But why did God get them across there? To lead them to a place that was overflowing with milk.
Yeah.
Amen. See, God always wants the abundance in our life. Yeah. Amen. He wants the overflowing ability. Y'all remember when the spies went into the land when they were over in the wilderness and brought back? And boy, they didn't bring back just grapes. They didn't bring back just watermelon. Them grapes were like, oh, it was just overflowing abundance. God wants us in the overflow. Amen? Now, I'm not just talking about natural things. He will bless us in that way too. But I'm telling you what, God will, if we're overflowing in here, God will cause the overflowing out there. And I'm reminded of the scripture that says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Everybody say, I got to keep the main thing. The main thing. Hallelujah. What about the disciples? They were in a wooden boat. Amen. Being tossed around by the storm and the mighty waters of the storm in Galilee. Amen. And Jesus slept in the back of the wooden boat. It doesn't matter how wet your wood is. Amen. If you got Jesus in your boat, you're going to be okay. even if it seems like he's sleeping and he ain't saying nothing. Because I want to tell you, Jesus not only speaks word, he is the word. And when the word speaks the word, whew, something happens. Amen. The boat of the disciples and the stormy wind and waves roared. But Jesus, the word, hallelujah, rose to his feet and spoke, peace be still. And the wind and the waves obeyed him. Hallelujah. The wind ceased. And the disciples went to being panicking for their life to saying, what kind of man? They had already seen what kind of man Jesus was. They seen him do all these miracles. But when he did that day, they said, what kind of man is this that even the wind and the waves obey him? Woo, glory. Everybody say, God is sent. Wood and word to help us in every situation. Hallelujah. Every time the enemy uses water to attempt to destroy God's people, it brings in opportunities for miracles to happen. I'm talking about trouble waters. And let's talk about the greatest flood that has ever hit the earth before. The flood of sin that happened in the garden when we failed as mankind and we opened the door to the flood of sin and rebellion to God. Amen. And we've all been drowning in it, fighting to stay ahead, trying to keep our head above water because this is a sinful world and there's always pull to try to pull us into the world's philosophies and the world's way of doing things. Amen. We wrestle against the world, the flesh, and the devil, and they're always vying for our opportunities and our attention. Amen. Hallelujah. It's there. It's real. It's a flood that seems to be rising. How many of y'all know water is getting high in this sin thing? Oh, but I've got good news for you.
Hallelujah.
Jesus built a bridge with the cross, the wooden cross that formed a way for us to cross over the troubled waters of life. There was no way around it or above it, but Jesus laid his life down, and by that wooden cross, he built a bridge for us to cross over and to redeem us from the sin of our past and cleanse us and to make us whole. And somebody say amen and amen and amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God's given us the victory. Amen. He ain't called you to drown. Amen.
Yeah.
Listen, if you're in troubled waters up to your neck, just start swimming. Amen. Just start moving. Amen. Start moving. Jesus is the rock. He hasn't called you to be the rock. Amen. If you pretend to be a rock, you're going to sink because that's not your call. Amen. He's the rock. He already paid the price. He built that bridge. Now he's called you to swim. He's called you to speak. Basically what he's saying, when I say he's called you to swim, he's called you to keep moving. Amen. Keep moving for God. Keep moving for God. What did that lady do at the well when Jesus spoke those words that pierced her heart? She moved. She left everything and ran into town. Man, y'all got to come see this guy. He told me everything I ever did in life. Amen. I love it when the townspeople went out and heard him and they believed because of her testimony. But then after a couple of days, they said, now we believe him because we've heard him and not because of your testimony. Praise God. Hallelujah. God can handle the water flow. And God can handle the flow of your troubles. He's given you a way over it through the cross. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever you're facing today, let me tell you what. Jesus makes a way where there seems like no way. And if it seems like your bridge has collapsed, guess what? Wood floats. Amen. Grab a hold and just float out of there. Amen. Hallelujah. Say there's one more than one way to skin a monkey. Anyway. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of y'all know that we always pray and we always see God answer it this way? God's promise is going to answer, but he may do it this way instead of this way. Would somebody, amen. Amen. There's things we've been praying out for years. I want it now. Amen. But God may be saying, there's an appointed time for this to bring me the most glory it could possibly happen. Amen. Are y'all hearing me this morning? Praise God. Everybody say, God is pouring out unto me, and I will allow him to pour into me so much that it will overflow out of me and splash on everybody around me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Listen, the fountain of his presence, y'all, is springing up into us. into eternal life. And that flow of God will always be stronger than the flow of the enemy.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Did you hear what I just said? The flow of God will always be more powerful surge than the flow of the enemy. And we have proof of that in Isaiah 59 and 19, which says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. Amen?
Amen.
Now, I've heard it preached, and I like to just read it like this. When the enemy comes in, like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against him. However you want to picture, whether it's God raising up a standard, a wall to push the water back, or whether you picture it as God bringing a mighty forceful flood that turns the current of the water going that way instead of this way, it don't matter. The bottom line is God is big enough to take control over the waters of trouble that try to come against you, and he will cause you to be the one that is overflowing and surging with the power of God. Would somebody say amen? Let's live in the overflow like a flood. Like the Spirit of God coming in. And I love Psalm 32 and 6, which says, for this shall everyone that is godly pray unto thee in a time when thou mayest be found. Surely in the floods of great waters they shall not come nigh unto him. God can protect you from the waters of life. And God will cause the true waters, the spiritual waters, to pour into you. And it will overflow from you. So my plea to y'all today is this. Just determine to live in the overflow of his presence. Amen. Be filled with the glory of God. Hallelujah. Oh man, I tell you what. That was a song we've been doing for years, but we hadn't done it in a long time. And tomorrow, let's do Show Me Your Glory this week. She put on this. Man, God moved in that song this morning. Did y'all feel the presence of God? He was talking and singing about the glory of God. Hallelujah. The glory of God. The glory of God. The glory. I tell you what, we can't talk enough about the glory. The glory of God is the description of everything that's in his presence. His light, his power, it's the glory of God. And God said he would glorify us. Hallelujah. But we must be full of him. Amen. We must allow him to splash out of us. Because if you stay filled, everybody say, if I stay filled, and how do you stay filled, remember? Talk to Jesus. Amen. Talk to him. Hear him. Be willing to move. Amen. If you stay filled with capacity, then every time you move, you're going to slosh out everywhere. Amen. Can't help but be a witness. You know, I believe in these last days that God is putting such an anointing on his people. And I want to tell you, too, I believe, because we are standing out like a sore thumb. Amen? Not a sore thumb to God or other believers, but we're a sore thumb to the world because when we come in contact with the spirit of the enemy in the world and we don't line up with that, it makes people very uncomfortable. Amen? So we stand out, and the more we stand out, God gives us the opportunity to be a witness. And what I'm saying is this, you can walk in somewhere, you walk in a restaurant, and there will be such an anointing on you, you don't have to say a word, but God will begin to minister by his Spirit just because of the presence, the glory that surrounds your life. I don't know about you, but I want to be one of those. Amen? Amen. If you want that, just say, God, glorify me. Glorify. And God said he would do it in Romans 8. Amen? He said, Jesus is the firstborn among many brethren. And whom he also, he called. He said, whom he also called, them he also justified. Whom he justified, them he also glorified. That's the state God wants us to be in, where we're carrying the glory of God. Let's splash on somebody this week. Amen? Let's be sure we have an encounter with Jesus at the well this week. Amen? And let him speak to us. And if we listen to him, he'll get us off of all the talk that don't really matter. He'll get us off of the religious mindset. He'll get us off of filling our own natural water pot. And he'll get us on the thing that really matters. And that is Him pouring living water into each one of our hearts to the point that we can go out in our day, our world every day, and we can be a full witness because the glory resides in us and we're willing to spill it all over people. Let me tell you what, you just live in that glory. Be a shining example of that to people. And I want to tell you what, they will come and ask for it sometimes. Amen? They will come and ask you for prayer. Why? Because they sense that glory and the anointing of the Lord on you. Amen? And it's time to live in the overflow. Amen? Of His glory. That speaks of ease. Amen? Living in the overflow. Let me tell you, when you overflow something, it's not you picking it up and with all this effort trying to pour this full thing into something else. No, it's just fill it and fill it and fill it and fill it until it's going everywhere.
Amen?
How many of y'all want to be a vessel like that? Amen? In fact, God said, I'm going to turn there and we'll end with this scripture. Go with it's 1 Corinthians chapter 4. This one just came to mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I believe it's 2 Corinthians 2. Sorry. 2 Corinthians 4. Oh, man, this is good. Listen, just read this here. It says, therefore, seeing we have this ministry. Y'all have this ministry. Amen? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
As we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. In other words, I want them to see, I want their conscience to know that I'm right with God by the way they see me. Now listen, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world, let me all know this, Satan, the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel should shine unto them, or lest the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. Hallelujah. Thank God for the light of the gospel. Amen. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commendeth the light to shine out of darkness, hath shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Now this is the scripture I was after right here. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels. Hallelujah. That the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. Hallelujah. We're going to be so full, we're going to be splashing on people that they know it's God. Then they know it's not us. There's no way we can just do that in ourselves. There's no way we can know that. I believe in the name of Jesus. I just prophetically, I speak over this congregation right now that some of you sit before me right now. You will begin to operate in the gift of the word of knowledge and the gift of the word of wisdom as you go out and minister to people in the world. What does that mean? The gift of knowledge is when God, which like Jesus flowed in with this woman, when God shows you something about a person and you know something about their life that nobody can know except God revealed it to you. The spirit of wisdom is that which gives you the anointed ability to speak a direction to them about their future, living in wisdom so that they can go in their future and have the results that God has for them. In the name of Jesus, I just came up my spirit. In the name of Jesus, I just speak that over y'all in Jesus' name, that those gifts will become reality in our lives, that as we minister out, that we would flow in the gift of the word of wisdom, the gift of the word of knowledge. Amen, in Jesus' name. And if we do that as Jesus did, people will be amazed. People will know that God's trying to reach them. I can't tell you in my experience as a Christian, as a young man, and some of the things that I went through, how that many times I was in a prayer line. Everybody say he was in a prayer line. He was in a church. Amen. And a man of God came and prayed over me and stopped and began to speak things into my life to me about my life that I ain't told anybody. Amen. And when that happens, something happens in here. It's like, okay, God, you have my attention now. So I knew that the next words coming out would be words that truly God is speaking to me. See, that has a place. And I'm telling you, I believe those gifts are going to be in reality as we witness to people in the world. Because I want to tell you, thank you, Jesus, for that. This is so good. Jesus operated in that gift of the Holy Ghost of the word of knowledge, as he told that lady, well, you're right, you don't have a husband. In fact, you've had five husbands, and the one you're with now, you're just living with, that's your husband. That was a word of knowledge. Jesus had no, but isn't it interesting that the word of knowledge through Jesus was operating at the well and not at the church? See, the gifts of the Spirit are not reserved for a church experience. Glory to God. Know this today. But as you spill over the presence of God in you, that God will, I'm not telling you to go out and oh, you have a message in tongue, an interpretation. You do that, they're going to think you're a lunatic. Amen. That God's chosen that to be an example to unbelievers in the church. It is. Amen. Hallelujah. But I'm talking about when you begin to reach out in love, spill whatever's inside of you, God is going to show up by his Spirit like Jesus is full of the Spirit. And it's going to start manifesting in ways that's going to blow you away too. Because God's going to cause you to say something to them sometime, and you're going to sit back and say, where did that come from? And you'll step away and know, man, I got to be used of God right there. Amen? Because how many of y'all know God loves them people out there? God loves all the lost people out there. And that's why he's going to bring them across our paths. And God is going to give us wisdom to be good workers in his field of harvest. Amen? But first, we got to be full. We got to spend time talking to him, receiving what he says, and be willing to run and be sloshy. Amen? And slosh it on everybody that's around. Hallelujah, glory to God. Aren't you glad that you know the living water today in Jesus' name? Stand with me if you will. Hallelujah.